Hello everyone. Today we will learn how to perform the experiment of photoelectric effect in the lab. What is photoelectric effect? Photoelectric has two terms in it, photo and electric. Photo means light, electric means electric current. So photoelectric is defined as the phenomenon of emission of electrons from particular metal surface when light of certain frequency falls on it. Now, photoelectric effect can be understood with the help of this diagram. Here, you can see that there is a surface. Now, this surface is the metal surface on which light is falling. So, this is source of light. This is the metal surface on which light is falling. So, when the light of suitable frequency falls on the metal surface, then the electrons from the metal surface are ejected. Now, here there is a cathode and when the electrons are ejected, they form a current in this circuit. The ejected electrons are called as photoelectrons, and the current that it constitutes is called as photocurrent. Now, what is the equation of photoelectric effect? So, here is the equation of photoelectric effect, where h nu is equal to kinetic energy maximum plus W. Here, h nu is the energy of incident photon. Kinetic energy max is the maximum kinetic energy of the ejected electrons, where this maximum kinetic energy of ejected electrons can be found by substituting this as equal to EV0, where E is the electronic charge, which is 1.6 into 10 to the minus 19 coulomb, and V0 is called as the stopping potential, which is the minimum voltage required to stop the ejection of photoelectrons. So, in this circuit, if this cathode is maintained at negative potential and if we keep on increasing the negative potential, then at one point of time, there will be no current in the circuit and no photoelectrons will be ejected. So, that negative potential is called as the threshold potential or stopping potential. Which, if we substitute in this equation, we can obtain the value of maximum kinetic energy. Then we have W in this equation. This W is called as work function, which is equal to H into nu naught. Here, nu naught is the threshold frequency, that is the minimum frequency of the incident light for which the photoelectric effect starts, which is also called as the threshold frequency. Now we'll see what do we require to perform this experiment. So to perform this experiment, we are going to use this instrument. Let us look at the circuit diagram and match with the instrument. So for performing this experiment, we need a metal surface. So there is a metal surface which is inside this box. Then we need a source of light. Here we have the source of light, where the intensity of the light can be adjusted using this knob. Then we need a voltmeter and an ammeter for measuring voltage and current, and we need a circuit where we can change the voltage. So here, this is the meter in which we can both read the current and voltage. So for reading the voltage, we need to switch the knob towards right hand side, where voltage can be read in terms of volts. To read current, we just have to bring this knob towards left hand side. Now whatever will be displayed will be current, and the unit of current will be microampere. Now if you want to see the result up to 3 decimal places, then this knob has to be placed at this multiplier. So this will display the result up to 3 decimal places. As I told you that this knob is for changing the intensity of light, and there is another knob which is for changing the voltage, which is called as voltage adjuster knob. Now, to do this experiment, as I told you that initially this has to be placed at zero potential. The cathode has to be at zero potential. Then initially, we keep on increasing the negative potential. And as the value of negative potential will keep on increasing, at one point of time, there will be no photocurrent in the circuit. So that value of negative potential is called as threshold value of potential. Since we need to apply reverse voltage, therefore, we have to do one more setting in this apparatus. This knob has to be set at right hand side, where a negative sign is there. So this way, whatever voltage is applied, that will all be negative potential. Next, we need light of different frequencies. So we do not have light of different frequencies, but we can always use different filters for that purpose. So if this filter I'm going to use, which is a red filter, and if I put here and if I switch on the light, it's already on, then whatever light is falling on the filter and passing through it, it will only allow the red light to pass through. So in this case, when I'm using this red filter, I can say that the light which is falling on the metal surface is red light, and we can note down the frequency of red light, and this way different frequencies can be used in this experiment. Begin the experiment. So this is the first part of the experiment. Here we will see a variation between frequency of light and maximum kinetic energy. So to study this variation, we will use light of different colors for different frequencies, and then we will obtain what is the stopping potential for each of the colors, and then using this formula EV0, we will calculate the maximum kinetic energy, and then we will plot a graph between different frequencies and the maximum kinetic energy, and we will see what is the nature. So to begin with, we have switched on from the main power supply, and then here this knob is adjusted to voltage. This knob is set at 0.001, which is the current multiplier, which will give value in 3 decimal places. Then we have to switch on this source of light, so that we can do from here. So you can hear the sound, it is switched on, and we can set this at any intensity. So let us set this at this particular intensity. Now there is nothing to measure the intensity. Just by looking at the brightness, you can yourself assume that what is the intensity. So intensity is increasing or intensity is decreasing. At least that inference can be drawn. So it is fixed at particular intensity. Now we do not need to touch this knob. After this, we have to make sure that this is reverse biased. And then slowly from here, we will keep on increasing the voltage. Now, but for that, we need to know that what is the frequency of light that is falling on the metal surface, which is inside the box. So we haven't used any filter. So let us start with blue filter. So if I'll put this blue filter inside, then this light after passing through this filter will allow only blue light to fall on the metal surface. So in this case, we are using blue light. So the frequency of blue light can be written. So we can use the standard frequency of blue light in this table. Then to find out what is the stopping potential, we have to keep changing the voltage from here. And then we have to keep on looking at the value of current. Presently, the voltage is zero. What is the current? You can see that the current is 0.070 microampere. This is the value of current at zero negative potential. We will slowly keep on increasing the negative potential, and then we will keep on looking into this meter where this is should be set at current, because we have to see what is the current and how the current is changing. So at one point of time, the current will be zero, and that point has to be noted. So let us see the change. So if I am increasing, so I'm moving this in the clockwise direction, and see here the value of current is reducing. The value is reducing. Now again, it is again further reducing. It is reducing. So as the magnitude of reverse bias potential is increasing, the value of current is decreasing. Now at one point of time, you will find out that the value of current will become zero. So we are now approaching that value. We are increasing the reverse current, and here we have got the value of zero. So this is the zero current, and we'll see that what is the corresponding voltage. So the voltage corresponding to which the current is zero is your threshold voltage. So to check the voltage, just switch this knob towards right hand side. So -0.63. So we will only note down the magnitude of stopping potential. So for blue light, it is 0.63 volts. So this is the value of threshold voltage for blue light, which is of a particular frequency. Then you can calculate E V naught. So multiplying V naught by E, where E is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. If you multiply this, you will get the value of kinetic energy. So you will have frequency, you will have kinetic energy, then a graph can be plotted. Now let us do the same thing for second. Let us do the same procedure for another color. So for green color, I'm using this green filter. Now the green colored light is falling on the metal surface. This voltage has to be put to minimum. And let us check the value of voltage, whether it is 0 or not. Yes, it is 0. Let us see the corresponding current. So this is the maximum current. Now slowly start increasing the value of voltage and look into this meter, and as soon as the current becomes 0, we have to stop at that point. So I'm increasing the voltage, which is the reverse potential, and we have to check when the current is 0, and at that point we have to stop. Now the value of current is 0, so the corresponding voltage is the threshold voltage. So for green color we have got the threshold voltage. We'll just write the magnitude 5.2 volts. So similarly, the kinetic energy can be obtained by multiplying this value by E, which is the electronic charge. Similarly, the same procedure can be repeated for rest of the colors, and then by obtaining the value of frequency from different texts and by calculating the value of kinetic energy for each of the threshold value of voltage for each different colors, you can have a range of values. And then if a graph is plotted between frequency and kinetic energy, then the expected graph is like this. So for a particular metal, so we are not changing the metal in this experiment, that is fixed inside the box. So for a particular metal, the graph should be a straight line graph like this. So as the frequency keeps on increasing, the kinetic energy of the emitted photoelectron must also increase. So this is the nature of the graph that will be obtained. We have come to the second part of the experiment. Here we will plot a graph between applied reverse potential and the photocurrent for a fixed intensity of light and for a fixed color of light. We will do first. So now we have used this red colored filter. So we are using red light. So you can note down the frequency of red light. You know what is that. And then you have to set the intensity. I've set the intensity. This is the intensity that we are going to take for this. So randomly it is set at particular value so that we will have a sufficient current in this meter. So that is the purpose of setting the intensity. Now the voltage has to be adjusted to 0 because we have to start from 0, and then by increasing the reverse potential, we'll keep on noting down the corresponding current. Now, so this particular intensity and red light, we are doing this. Let us note down the current for 0 potential. So the applied reverse potential is 0 volt. What is the corresponding current? So look at the current. It is 0.072 microampere. Now let us change the value of voltage. So we will keep on changing the voltage in very very small steps because we need a large number of data. I have only written here 10, but actually till 15-20 readings have to be taken to have a proper graph. So next the voltage can be set to 0.01. so the value of voltage is 0.01 volt. We are noting down only the magnitude. And what is the corresponding current? So the corresponding current is 0.063 microampere. Similarly, just move on to the next voltage. So the next voltage can be taken at an interval of 0.01. So now it is 0.02 volt and the corresponding current is 0.061 microampere. Similarly, keep on noting down the result. So we'll have a range of value, and we have to stop when the value of current becomes 0. So this value, as you can see, is decreasing. So we have to keep on noting down the value till we get the value of current as equal to 0, and then the graph will look like this. So for a particular intensity, so we haven't touched the knob yet, so intensity is fixed. So for a particular intensity, the graph will be like this. Now to have second set of reading, we just need to change the intensity. So for doing the second set of reading, we can again adjust this knob to 0, and we can change the intensity. Let us increase the intensity further, and the color of the light is same. We are using red filter, so red light is falling on the metal, and set the knob to 0 so that the voltage is 0, and then again from here start the experiment. So now the intensity is changed, so you will have to draw another table because it is next intensity. So since we are not able to measure the intensity, you can say that this is I1, and since we are now increased the intensity, so the second table can be written as I2, which is greater than I1. So you know that how the intensity is changing by simply looking into the brightness of this light source. So the same procedure can be repeated and graph can be plotted. So you will get a graph like this. So at zero applied potential, you know the current is maximum, and as you keep on increasing the reverse potential, the current starts decreasing. At one point of time, the value of current will be 0. So from here maximum to minimum, the readings has to be taken, and the graph will come like this for different intensities of light. Now we have come to the third part of the experiment. In this part, we will plot a graph between the applied reverse potential and the corresponding photocurrent for a given color. So we'll keep on changing the color and keep on noting down these values for a given color, and then we'll do for next color and next color. So for different fixed frequencies, we are going to plot graph between applied potential and the photocurrent. So let us now begin by choosing any one color. So let us do with orange color. So let us put this orange color filter over here. Now the orange light is falling on the metal surface. Intensity is fixed at a particular value. We need not note down the value. Just we have to set the knob of the voltage so that it is 0. So now the value is 0. So what is the voltage value? It is 0 volt, and the corresponding current for orange color is coming out to be 0.352 microampere. Now let us change the value of voltage from here in small steps. So we can use the step as 0.01. So now next value of voltage is 0.01 volt. And see what is the corresponding current. So corresponding current is 0.325 microampere. You can see that as the voltage, reverse voltage is increasing, the corresponding current is decreasing. So let us do for one more value of voltage. So you have to do for whole range of voltage. Now it is 0.02 volt, and the corresponding current is 0.315 microampere. So similarly, keep on doing this experiment till the value of current becomes equal to 0. So till that value, you have to keep noting down the values, and then the graph that you will get between the applied reverse potential and photocurrent is like this. So for different frequencies, different graphs will be obtained. So for an orange colored light, you will have one graph. For if you are using red color, you will have different graph. For green color, you will have different graph. For blue color, you will have different graph, and so on. So this will be the nature of the graph. So these graphs will help you understand the photoelectric effect and how various quantities changes when we change the source of light, when we change the intensity of light, what happens to the kinetic energy, what happens to the current, and so on. So all these information you will get after you will perform the experiment and draw these graphs. So I hope this experiment is now understandable to you and you will be able to perform in your lab. Thank you for watching.